Y'all don't mind. That was not the right list. But I saw some of y'all faces when I did that, though. Okay, I guess that I'm presenting myself to some and introducing myself to others. I'm the artist James Murphy Jr. And first of all, I just want to thank all of you for taking time out of your day to come down and check out my art show, you know, and be a part of my artist reception. So thank you so much for that. And I guess a little bit about me. I've been doing artwork since I was in the fourth grade. And it was in the fourth grade that I realized that an artist is what I wanted to be. Art is what I wanted to pursue as a career. I went to Baltimore School for Arts High School. And it was a real blessing to be able to, at a high school level, be able to undertake a art education on a college level, and that prepared me and gave me a little bit of advantage in my art studies. I went on to the Brownstone College of Arts, where I have a BFA in visual communication, and I studied illustration. And you probably, in some of my drawings, see an illustrative style. After college, I went on to freelancing, and I did artwork for magazines. There was a local magazine here in Baltimore that I did illustrations for. I believe it's called Physical Therapy Today. They're not around anymore, but also I did illustrations for a local greeting card company called Emoji Children, illustrations for them. After that, I was blessed to be able to work with a local artist. Many of you know him, Larry Poncho Brown. And when I worked for him, he introduced me to a lot of opportunity. And sometimes when I think when I work for him, it's like, what did he not have me doing? He had me working in his office. We traveled throughout the country for different shows and festivals to set up his artwork. But then it got to a point where he had asked me, you know, what am I waiting on? When am I going to start my art business? And at that point, I hadn't really even considered that, because I went to college for visual communication. I was a freelance illustrator, and I was still going freelance on the side. I had never really considered being, a full-time artist to this degree. So with this prompting, he helped me get my website started and launch my business, Something for Your Soul. Now, Something for Your Soul is not only the name of my business, it's also, of course, as you see, the name of my exhibit, but also it's the name of my signature angel piece that's back there in the corner. That's also called Something for Your Soul. And the name Something for Your Soul was significant to me because it's, your soul is the deepest part of yourself that you identify with. As far as when you love a piece of music, when you love a piece of artwork, or if you love someone else, you know, that is a soul exchange. You know, so thus, the name Something for Your Soul, because ultimately when you purchase my artwork, when you acquire my artwork, it's for your wall, but also primarily it's for your soul satisfaction. That's Something for Your Soul. About my artwork, my subject matter is African-American and nature, because for my subject matter, I draw from my life's experiences. So my life experience is an African-American experience. So thus, the images that you see. My imagery encompasses a range of topics from angels, dancers, family, couples, and I'll summarize my artwork in a brief statement that I've come to call my artist statement. I'm a husband and a father. I'm a man of faith as well as a man of color. And it's these aspects of my being that I seek to explore and express through my artwork. And finally, because I told you I wasn't going to be long, finally, I want to thank the Living Classroom for the availability in this beautiful gallery. want to thank Khabib for being such a wonderful curator, you know, and pretty much laying out the show that you see before you. I want to thank my wife and my son for, you know, being a part of, I guess you could call, Team Murphy, you know, for being able to help out when we do shows and festivals and helping prepare and break down things. And also want to thank, again, you all for your attendance and coming out to my art reception. I appreciate you all. And if you have any questions or anything about any of my pieces that you need to know, I'm available to talk and mingle. Thank you.